हेलो व्यूअर्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर पद्मश्री, लेक्चरर इन जियोलॉजी, गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज ऑटोनोमस अनंतपुर. सी, ड्यूरिंग दिस COVID-19 लॉकडाउन पीरियड, एवरीबडी इज सीइंग वन ब्यूटिफुल विजुअल आउटसाइड. व्हाट इज इट? क्लियर एनवायरनमेंट, ब्यूटिफुल स्काई, क्लियर स्काई, इजंट इट? सो देन आई थॉट, व्हेन आई सॉ द क्लियर स्काई, I thought, let me introduce you all to nephology. What is this? We heard about geology. What is this nephology? Nephology is the study of clouds, beautiful structures above. When we look above in the sky, in the clear sky, you can see white, you can see gray colored, you can see linings, you can see stratified, you can see patches, so many types of varieties. And when you are kids, you will be visualizing them like they are like cows, they are like nation's borders, they are like bunny rabbits and what not. So I thought, let me introduce you to the study of clouds, that is nephology, a very very important branch in meteorology. All of us should know, because we are living on this earth, we are dependent on rain. And clouds are the very very important factors which give us rain from the top. So we should all know as geology students, what are clouds, what is nephology, what are the various types of clouds, and how do you classify them. Okay, what is a cloud? See, a cloud is an aggregate of either water droplets or ice or both. And you know the size of the particle, it is of a very minute size, less than 0.1 mm diameter. So less than 0.1 mm diameter particles, they come as aggregates, and then you can see the clouds on your top moving continuously, ready to rain on you, ready to shower water, the elixir of life, on you. Okay, so cloud is that mass which contains particles of either water droplets or ice particles, or both the particles, very minute in size. Then how does it happen? All of you know, as we move up, up means as we move towards higher altitudes, the pressure decreases. And when the pressure decreases, the water vapor, how the water vapor comes? It will be coming from so many bodies. There are oceans, there are rivers, there are tanks, wells, even the transpiration from your bodies, the respiration from the plants, everywhere you get moisture, water vapor, which will move up. And when it moves up in the higher altitudes, what happens? The pressure decreases, and this water vapor, it is condensed as minute droplets, and all of them come together, and that is called your cloud. Okay, so that is called your cloud. The aggregate of this entire water droplets is called a cloud, which will be on the higher altitudes in stratosphere, troposphere, mesosphere. Okay, so troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, you can see these clouds. Sometimes they'll help us in raining, and sometimes they are also obstructive for aviation, for aeroplanes and what not. Now let us all see into what are the various types of clouds, and in various heights how they are formed, what are their names, how can you identify them, all these things. Now let us see. The clouds are classified on the basis of two important types. One is on the basis of their shape, form and structure, they are given some names. And the second one is based on their altitude. So high altitude, middle, low. Okay, so they are classified in two ways. One is on the basis of their structure, form and shape, and the second one is on the basis of their height, altitude. Okay, now first let us see how they are classified on the basis of shape, form and size. Okay, so on the basis of shape, form and size, clouds are classified mainly into three types. Okay, the first one is cirriform clouds. The first one is cirriform clouds. Second one is stratiform clouds. Third one is cumuliform clouds. Cirriform, stratiform, cumuliform are the three important types of clouds. The division is based on their shape, form and structure. Okay, cirriform, stratiform, cumuliform. Now let us see what is cirriform cloud. Cirrus means what? The Latin meaning of cirrus is hair like, fibrous. Okay, so the cloud will be having hair like appearance, fibrous appearance. The entire white mass, it is white in color, and the white mass will be spread in the form of patches or fibrous hair like appearance. Therefore it is called cirriform cloud. And you know, it is formed in higher altitudes, and also it will be having ice crystals. Okay, cirriform clouds formed in higher altitudes, and cirrus means hair like. They will be having fibrous appearance, they are white in color. Okay, and they will be having ice crystals. So these are called cirriform clouds. Cirriform clouds are transparent, white in color, containing ice crystals and are fibrous in appearance. They are occur in higher altitudes. Now what is a stratiform cloud? Strata means layers. So here again I want to tell you one thing. Cirriform clouds are detached, they are individual, whereas stratus clouds or stratiform clouds spread continuously as layers. Okay, they are continuous layer type. They are gray in color, and you know, they are a big nuisance to aviation because they are in a little bit lower level where the planes fly, and they are a nuisance to the aviation also. Okay, and you know, stratiform clouds contain minute droplets of snow and ice prisms also. And when this stratiform cloud, stratum, reaches the ground, that is nothing but your fog. You get the fog. So these are the two varieties, cirriform, stratiform. Now what is the third variety? Cumuliform. Cumulus, all of us know, cumuli means mass, piling, a group. So again, cumuliform clouds, they are a group of clouds piling upon one another, and you can see a tower like form. All the masses combined in a tower like form, and that bulging part will resemble some cauliflower also. And these are also detached clouds. And here, you know, when the sunlight passes through these clouds, they will have a very brighter appearance. This is cumuliform clouds. So based on their shape, size and structure, clouds are classified into three types: cirriform, hair like fibrous structures, white in color; stratiform, layered gray in color; and cumuliform structures, which are like a tower, bright in appearance. Okay, based on the height, clouds are again classified into three types: high clouds, middle clouds, low clouds. Okay, then what are high clouds? The clouds which are up to the height of 6100 meters are called high clouds. 6100 meters height, the clouds are called high clouds. So due to that highest elevation, they are very thin, they are white in color, they compose ice crystals. Okay, so regarding the high clouds, they are height up to the height of 6100 meters, they are very thin, they are white in color, and they compose ice crystals. And they are divided into three varieties. Already we know regarding the shapes: cirrus, stratus, cumulus, etc. Here the high clouds are classified into three types. They are cirrus, cirrocumulus, cirrostratus. So high clouds again classified into three types: cirrus, cirrocumulus, cirrostratus. Okay, cirrus is the most common type of clouds that can be seen throughout the year. So throughout the year, 365 days, you can see these clouds. They are thin, wispy, with a silky sheen appearance. So cirrus clouds, you can see throughout the year, they are very thin and silky. And they are always made up of ice crystals. Earlier also I told you, the clouds which are in the higher altitudes will have ice crystals. And they are very transparent. And before the sunrise or sunset, you know, they are often colored as bright red or yellow. Okay? And see, they are the first clouds to come out and they are the last clouds to fade out. So during the sunrise and sunset, they are seen in bright red or bright yellow colors. They are thin filament like structures and they are made up of ice, transparent. So all these are the characteristic features of cirrus clouds which are seen throughout the year. Next is cirrocumulus. They are beautiful, gorgeous clouds. Once you see the cirrocumulus clouds, you can easily feel they are the most gorgeous clouds. They form at about 5 kilometers above the surface with small white fluff-like patterns. So this white fluff-like pattern will spread miles and miles over the sky. They have a grayish color and sometimes, you know, the sky will look like the scales of a fish. All of you know how the body of the fish will be. It will be having some scales. Even these clouds, which are gray in color, will look like fish scales. So why they are called cirrocumulus clouds? You know, cirro means hair like and cumulus means mass, piling. Cirrocumulus clouds exhibit both the features of cirrus as well as cumulus. Therefore, they are called cirrocumulus clouds. Okay? And you remember one thing, my dear viewers. One important feature about cirrocumulus clouds is they will never generate rainfall. They will never generate rainfall. They may give very cold weather, but they will never generate rainfall. And they do not interact with other types of clouds to form large structures. So they are individual, independent. They will never combine with other clouds to form huge structures. So this is a very, very important feature about cirrocumulus clouds. Looking like fish scales, gray in color, they will never give rainfall and they will never combine with other clouds to form large structures. And the third one is cirrostratus. Cirrostratus clouds, sheet-like appearance. Okay? You can just think that there is a big blanket which is covering the sky. They will give you sheet-like appearance. They are translucent so that the sun and moon can easily pass through them. They are translucent. They will allow the sun's light and moon's light to pass them through easily. And their color varies from light gray to white. And they are fibrous bands. Always they move in the west direction. And you know, once you see these clouds, cirrostratus clouds, that means you are going to get rainfall within 24 hours. So they are the sign of rainfall within 24 hours. These three are the important varieties of high clouds: cirrus, cirrocumulus and cirrostratus. The three important high altitude clouds around 6,100 meters height. Thin, containing ice, some will give rainfall, some will indicate the occurrence of rainfall. Okay? And now, the middle level clouds at a height of 1980 meters. So 6,100 meters, up to 6,100 meters is high level clouds. Now up to the height of 1980 meters, we call them as middle level clouds. Okay, so here they are gray in color, and you know they are the bodies which contain water, and we get rain, either gentle rain or lot of showering rain we get from them. They are called middle level clouds. They are again divided into three types. Okay, altocumulus, altostratus and nimbostratus. Altocumulus, altostratus and nimbostratus are the three varieties of middle level clouds. Then what is an altocumulus cloud? Altocumulus clouds, they form at lower altitudes and they contain water droplets. Okay, they are common in most parts of the globe. Usually they grow by convection and they will be containing water in them, and they will also combine with other clouds, you know, like cumulonimbus, and they will give rainfall also. Then altostratus, already you know strata means layers. They are spread over thousands and thousands of square miles, and they are linked always to light rain or snowfall. So if it is a light raining, then you should think it is an altostratus cloud. They don't give heavy rain, they will give only light rain. And sometimes if they go and merge into nimbostratus clouds, again they will give heavy rain also. So they are always gray in color, spread over long distances, and they will give you light rain. But when combined with the nimbostratus, they will give heavy pounding, heavy rain. And what are nimbostratus clouds? The most important clouds. Nimbus itself means rain. The meaning of nimbus is rain. Stratus means spreading. Lot of rain spreading out is called a nimbostratus cloud. And these gloomy clouds, once you see the sky, if it is gloomy, then you will think the rain is going to come. They are called your nimbostratus clouds, and they will give you heavy rain, heavy rain. And they are form thick dark layers of clouds, and they will block out the sun. Once the nimbostratus cloud comes, you can't see the sun. The sun is blocked. Though sometimes they are in the middle level only, but sometimes they will come even to the lower levels also. Okay, so the most important clouds which give you heavy rain are nimbostratus clouds. Now the third variety of clouds, low level clouds, which appear at a height less than 1980 meters, are called low level clouds. They are of four varieties. They are stratus, that is layered clouds, cumulus, that is piling clouds, and then cumulonimbus. Okay, cumulonimbus, nimbus means rain, cumulo means pile, and stratocumulus. So four varieties of clouds are again there. Now let us see one by one. What are these low level clouds? Stratus. The stratus clouds are composed of thin layers of clouds. They cover large areas of the sky. They are having just mist or fog. So once they come very close to the ground, they will give you nothing but fog. They always look like fog-like appearance. They are very common in most parts of the world, in the coastal regions as well as in the mountainous regions. And cumulus, a large white mass. So heap, cumulus means heap. So heap of clouds, large white clouds, which will give us light showers, are called cumulus clouds. So we can find them in all parts of the world. And what is cumulonimbus? cumulonimbus clouds are white. They are also white like cumulus clouds, but they are far larger clouds. So their base starts from 1 to 8 kilometers and therefore it is always called a lower cloud. It is always a lower cloud. It is cumulonimbus we can see in the lower levels as well in the higher levels also. It is mostly made up of water droplets in the lower level and ice crystals in the upper level. See, when this cloud comes, rain comes. When this cloud goes, rain goes. But you know, it is always associated with pouring. Therefore, whenever you see a cumulonimbus cloud, you can also listen. You can see that there is a thunderstorm. The clouds, which the rain which is associated with thunderstorms is related to this cumulonimbus clouds. So usually, you know, in summer afternoons and spring months, the earth's surface suddenly releases the heat. Then you can see this type of cumulonimbus clouds. So cumulonimbus clouds are seen in the afternoons of summer, in the afternoons of spring season, when suddenly the heat is released. So whenever the cloud comes, it will get you rain, and when it goes, it will take the rain along with it, and you will can visualize the thunderstorms in the sky. These are cumulonimbus clouds. Then what are stratocumulus clouds? Stratocumulus clouds, they are like white blankets stretched. They are, we can think, a blanket made up of white cotton, that is nothing but a stratocumulus clouds. They are very, very bigger. They are also like cumulus clouds, but they are little bit bigger, and the base is well defined in them, and thick rain. See, whenever these clouds come, stratocumulus clouds, people will be thinking we'll get very heavy rain. But no, even if you get a light drizzling, you are very lucky. They will give you the impression that they are going to give you a heavy rain, but they won't give any heavy rain. And if you are getting a slight drizzling rain also, you are very, very lucky. Okay? So these are the important types of clouds. So dear viewers, with this background knowledge, if at all if you see any cloud, now it is summer, and in the afternoons of summer, sometimes you may see a cloud, and even in rainy season you may see a cloud, and whenever you just see the clear sky and if you see the clouds, okay, then try to visualize whether they are cirrus, stratus, cumulus, nimbus, altostratus, altocumulus, cumulostratus, cumulonimbus, or whatnot. Thank you for a patient listening.